हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू ए न्यू वीडियो। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो आई टोल्ड यू हाउ टू क्रिएट द ऑटोमेटिक स्टिमुली वेक्टर टू गेट 100% कवरेज, एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल लेट यू नो हाउ यू कैन जनरेट द रिपोर्ट टू सी वेदर योर कवरेज इज 100% और नॉट। सो आई एम ओपनिंग माई सिम मॉडल नाउ एंड आई ऑलरेडी परफॉर्म द मिल एंड ऑलरेडी क्रिएटेड द ईपीवी प्रोफाइल। So if you don't know how to create the EPP profile and take the test vector inside the EPP profile, so kindly refer to that video. So here you can see my sim model is opening, and in the above you can get the BTC embedded platform box in blue color. So once the model will be load completely, you have to double click on that and you can see here your embedded platform is opening. So once the embedded platform will be loaded, I will open my EPP profile over there and will see how I will perform the testing and will get the coverage reports. So it is opening, it will take couple of minutes for the opening operation. So generally why we will perform SIL is to verify whether the data ranges and the code ranges are matching or not. So in the interview question also they will ask you why you are doing the mill testing and after that you are performing SIL testing. It's because in the SIL testing we are taking the reference for the mill testing output, and from the code we are generating another output and checking whether both the results are matching or not. So the whatever result we are getting from the mill, that should match with our SIL result, then the SIL testing will pass. So here I opened my EPP, you can see it, and like I have to click on the requirement based testing here. So in the next down tab you can see for the BTC testing you will get another tab. So by default my coverage is 100%, so no need of generating automatic stimuli. So click on B2B testing and you have to give the tolerance limit if you are not testing for boolean other values, and you can give like 0.004 also. Here you can see all the test cases are passed. So I right click on the TL mill versus SIL and generated the report, code coverage report and the analysis report. So for the now I am going to save the report. So here you can see my coverage is 100%. So this is the desired result to get the 100% coverage. If it is not there, then your testing is not passed. So I am choosing my location and saving the value over there. So here in the location you have to create a folder inside the test folder named as something like for analysis report. If you are you want to create new folder, and you have to give the name as analysis report, and in that folder automatically this value will be stored. So here I am opening it and you can see inside the report folder you can see the report is already being generated. So you have to give a name for it, copy paste and save the report and submit it in the cases if it is needed. Thank you guys, thank you for watching this video.